Sound check, guys. Testing 1, 2, 3. G'day, Dave. Thunderbird 1. Rob H. Rob H, you can't have a name like that in this room, sir. You'll have to change it because that's mine. Hola, Hector. ¿Cómo estás? Morning, guys. Welcome to FX Bootcamp, guys. American session has been made possible by the financial support of FXCM and the use of their MT4 trading platform. However, FX Bootcamp is an independent educational organization, and the training and analysis provided today is based on my experience as a currency trader and should not be considered the advice or opinion of FXCM. Also, guys, I want you to trade on your demo accounts, and regardless of trade plans are successful or not, you'll have an opportunity to learn. Remember, investing and trading is a very risky business. Most of you are leveraged at least 50 to 1 or more, even more than that. As a novice trader, you're finding this is only sometimes working for you, but often working against you. Also, please remember your past performance does not predict future results, and therefore do not trade the money you could not afford to part ways with. How are you guys doing? I'm here to pick up the dregs of the day. Last session of the day. Everything's done, is it? Oh, it's great to be here, Ruben. Thank you for sharing your US session with me. What do you think here on this Euro? A long-term descending channel? Daily chart? Euro? Is that a channel forming or what? I don't know. I was just been thinking about it. Hands up. What do we got? 44 people or so in the room. A weekly range, possibly, Dave. Who knows? Weekly range is cool. We can trade a weekly range, though. That's hundreds and hundreds of pips, isn't it? Up and down, up and down. Short it, long it, no-brainer. Off we go. So, I'm just going to go to my little scan. You'll notice my charts may be a little bit different to what you're used to if you're a regular New Yorker and you're not au fait with me at all. But that's cool. It's always good to have a little bit of different experience from somebody, you know. You might pick a couple of things up. Now, tell me, hands up, honest to God, hands up here. Who in the room has been sitting sort of watching the charts over the past few weeks, hasn't really managed to get themselves in a euro short or in a pound short or an Aussie short or anything, and they're sitting there today, so they've watched all this come down here, they haven't really been able to get in it, and we're here today. Who is sort of scratching their head over their next move they should be taking? Show of hands, who's a little bit like, not sure. Wait for what, Dave? But what are you waiting for? You channeling the universe and hoping that you're just sort of going to sit up right in bed one morning this week and something's going to hit you and say, short it. You don't want to buy it? Right. Okay, well, let's just break a few things down. It's all about, if you're not sure what you want, sometimes it's sort of, you sort of look at your charts in a slightly different way, and then it helps you sort of maybe devise what your bias is, and then allows you to build sort of trade plans around that. Okay, so, by the way, you're about to find out how I like to have sort of long, medium, and short-term biases. Here's our Euro daily chart. Okay. We have we've been in this big fat trap over here, haven't we? This highlighting. We're in this trap for a good chunk of time. And we had 130 sort of holding this up for the longest time. Several months, if you like, almost. Okay, finally broken, and down we've come, and we're here in this little zone here, which some people might look at this as being a potential, because it's not yet, but double bottom or something. So there could be people, there will be people out there that believe something like, oh yeah, that is going to do that. Okay, that's how that looks. Okay, but other people will be looking at something like this, and I will take it more people in the room will be looking at something like this. Back to there, down, or even back to there and down. Okay. This is why it's important. Right. It's all about having an opinion and a bias, right? Martin's all over it. How you doing, sir? So this is why it's important to have your long-term charts, guys. I too prefer this. Looking for something like that. That's my personal preference because this is the last area to be broken. This one here that I highlighted before. And I would like to see something back up to resistance in terms of role reversal. That's what we call support being broken, now acting as resistance. It's also the 130 psych level. And no doubt there'll be a truckload of pivots and various other things that'll be there. And it's also a 618 retracement if I throw this up here. As Carl mentions, it's a 618 of that little move there, or from the entire highs, that drop, it's right bang smack around 50, 382 to 50%. So it all fits the fibby fib fibs very well. Okay, so that's the way I look at it. Cool. Well, we're at 127.62 right now, and we're looking at 130. So if I do my math, that's 240 pips up the road. Now, if you're a very, very conservative trader and you're looking at something like that, you maybe have a screenshot, written, scribbled some notes on it. Sometimes I like to get charts like this, and I like to draw, believe it or not, pretty shapes on it like that, just to remind me. So I don't have to reanalyze all the time. I just look at my chart and there's a rectangle there saying, oh, it's just, I might make it red. Okay. Oh, it's a sell area. That's where I want to sell that thing from. So I'm not having to reanalyze all the, every time, every day I sit down, I don't have to do my analysis. I just sort of pull up my daily chart. Oh, there's my sell zone. All right, cool. Okay, so I want to sell from there, probably like most of the people in this room. Okay. Now, as I was saying, you don't have to. You can sit and be patient, and maybe this week or next week it's going to get up there, and that's when it's time to go to work, right? Get up into this area up. Get into that area up the road up there, and you're going to have to camp out and use your little trading tactics that you have as an individual and wiggle your way into the short. Okay, so that's cool. Yeah, nothing wrong with all that. You might be having the week off or several days off, and then suddenly, oh, now it's work time. So now I'm gonna go lock myself in a cave and sit there patiently and see how many attempts it takes me to get in the short here. Okay, and hopefully, that's what happens, and it's all gonna be good. Well, I look at it like that's my long-term bias. Okay, long-term bias down. Okay, now sometimes to get to the area of your long-term bias where to short it, which is the red rectangle there, maybe your short-term or medium-term bias has to turn around to be long for a while to go and meet your short-term bias. Okay. So if we look at that same move, here's let me put a fib up there. This is the same fib I think Carl was referring to. And this is our short zone here. That's that beautiful looking roll reversal area. Okay. Well, we obviously, this chart here needs to sort of follow. Try and, it might even do something like this, and then it's going to sort of get itself up there, right? 4 hour chart, would you agree? Right, so four-hour chart's got to get it's got to wiggle its way up there, which means if you're a little bit more aggressive, I mean this is still fairly conservative in the general forex world, okay? But you can we can plan to long up to that area, okay? And I've already had in the back of my mind, I've been, and this is how I've been basically telling my Asia class for the last chunk of time, that I have wanted it back up here to short, where I'm putting the yellow paintbrush again, the wide line there, that's where I want to short it in the longer term, based on what my daily fractal chart is telling me. Just thinking fractals here. And the first thing that'll get me into the long will be off an area of support, a 4 hour change of trend. What's happened in the last sort of 24 hours on the euro here? It's made a higher high with reference to the swings that were coming down. So we're swinging down, and suddenly we've gone boom. So we've essentially had a 4 hour change of trend off this area down here. I'm not sure what it was, what caused it. Maybe if I throw up this pivots chart here, it could help us. So if I, it's a 15-minute chart. Okay, so we had happened on Friday. There was a monthly S3 there, and I'm pretty sure there was another pivot there at the same time, like a daily S2 or something. Okay, so great. Found some support, came off some pivots. Maybe a pivot mid-cycle level around 126.50. A day, was it an M1, was it? I mean, maybe something like that. Anyway, found a couple of areas of support, and off we go. So good. Things are falling into place sort of for me here. I'm starting to see what I want. Okay, I'm looking for a sort of medium term trade long Okay, back to my sell zone to give this the big kahuna short. And my 4 hour chart over here is setting up for the long. If you want to take it, I mean, you don't have to, you could be sitting there going, dude, don't long this. You don't want to be longing in this market. That's cool. If you're going to stay short, that's fine. You could even be short, couldn't you, today? Is anyone short today? Around 28, 10 or 20 or whatever it was, 15. Looks feasible. There's a daily R2 up there, short from 82. Sort of scalped your way in there, Jonathan, have you? So, yeah, if we look at just back at that pivots chart real quick, we have reached, we're not near a fib zone of the drop or anything, but around a combination of monthly S2, daily R3, but there's a daily R2 right in this little area up there. So it's feasible that things are turning around. So if you're bearish, hopefully you're in it around 128.10 or whatever, and you're like 50 pips up right now. It's a good trade. It's a good trade for a Monday to get the week kicked off. Myself, I'm gonna shoot for a long up to higher levels, looking for a further short. Okay, so I'm gonna line me up some sort of long here and see how we go. So if I'm thinking long and I have my 4 hour change of trend, I need an area of support now to long from, right? If you're bullish. If you're bullish, so I need to be thinking, I'm thinking sort of medium term bullish here, right? My medium term bias, guys, is like several days to a week. 2 or 3 days to a week is my medium term. If you ask me, oh, what's your projection for the euro in the next coming weeks or months, I'll say I'll be bearish. Until I see that like daily chart sort of wholesale turnaround, it's I'm bearish on it. But medium term on this 4 hour chart, this 4 hour chart's turned itself around. And so I feel that because I've had a 4 hour change of trend, which usually, by the way, can take several days to turn itself around. Okay, to change trend. See, to change this trend up here, let me just highlight for you. Something like from the highs, where we're swinging up, swinging up, swinging up, down. And here's our change of trend, pretty much. That's probably 2.5 days. These dotted lines are entire days, so it takes a while to turn these things around sometimes. Therefore, I believe that you're good for a swing or two before you find support or resistance. So, likewise over here, with this thing's turned itself around, can we get a fib of this rise and go and do something like this? So, can we get this back to an area like the 50% fib, a little bit of roll reversal, or maybe like a 618, a little bit of psych level? Down, bang, up, make 100 to 200 pips long, and then drop two hammers on it and see how many hundred of pips we can make to the short side. That's my theory, and that's what I'm basing everything on. We've been down for a chunk of time. I think it's time to go catch up with some high level charts, and so that's what I'm looking at. Okay, so let's just look at it for some support. You need support to buy off, right? And then we'll go from there. Now, if you've been in my sessions, you're going to know I'm huge on pivots and their overlaps. Okay. So anywhere you've got support where there's within sort of maybe like a 10 pip range, you've got multiple pivot areas. I sort of look at that as being a pretty good heads up for support or resistance. Okay. Also, I do look at things like individual pivots mixed with roll reversal. For example, a daily S2 at 27.31, which is only 20 pips up the road, is pretty nice roll reversal with this is last Thursday and last Friday. So a couple of little areas there. Daily S1 where we are, well, that's with this whole, let me just zoom out a level. That's this whole area through sort of here as well. So any of these little areas, if I get a response in here, and this would be my final one, if I get a change of trend here on my 15-minute chart, okay, so let me draw on the 15-minute chart what I'm referring to. I'm gonna grab the fib. Okay, so if we come down to my little area here, maybe 382, this little area here, and we get a 15-minute change of trend, I'm gonna long it. That's my trade plan, but I need my confirmation. My confirmation is my change of trend, okay? So let me move this to the right. If we come down, let's say this happens in New York. If we swing down here, tag our little 50% fib, our roll reversal area here. Okay, this 127.30 area. And then we get some sort of hello. I'm finding buyers here. At this level, I'm finding more buyers than sellers. And we can knock a few of the recent sellers, like the people that shorted where I'm putting this blue circle. If we can knock them out of the market, and then we can maybe pop up here. I will do take something and take a shot at longing it with a little lower low stop and see how we go. Make sense? Now, what's important here is I might be bullish medium sort of term, short to medium term, if you like. I might be bullish, but I need the confirmation. Does not mean I'm longing here no matter what. No. Because do not underestimate what this daily chart's been doing longer term. And could we just roll over here and come down here? Absolutely. I'm well aware. That's why for me, the confirmation is everything, is going to be everything on that area of support. If we come down here and we do not get any confirmation and it just keeps doing, hello, yep, I'm just not getting in the long. Obviously, I missed the short up here, so I'm not in that. So I'm a spectator. Okay, very important point. And I'm waiting for a 15-minute change of trend, guys. I'm not going to namby-pamby around with my 1-minute Stokes crosses or 5-8 crosses or anything like that. That's not enough. You need to show that. You need to show. I'll show you on the 15-minute. Sorry. We need to show that people are starting to buy in an area. This here, guys. This is selling. After resistance, people have sold it, continued to sell it, continued to sell it. If we do this, they'll be continuing to sell it. That is not an excuse to buy. Okay, until we get an area where those people selling got knocked out of the market, and then we get sort of heads up that at support, people are now doing the reverse of what happened up here. Okay, so something to think about. But that's what I'm waiting for. It's going to have to confirm and all that sort of stuff. Now, that's a bit of a problem for me, isn't it? In terms of, this is New York. It's about to get underway here soon. And this 15-minute chart's still trending down. And it can take several hours to turn the chart around. I'm aware of that. And it's sometimes that sort of time of day factor is something that can keep me out of the long. And I might have to wait for Asia or something. Okay, we might do this today. New York might bring us down. Comes down to where I'd like to long it. But then it sort of just goes, sort of just mucks around here for like half a day. I have to come back for Asia and hope for, okay, found some support, long, off we go, and see if it will hold for London and all that good stuff. And I can maybe be getting myself out 100 and 150 pips up the road at some daily extreme resistance or something. Okay, so is that clear to everyone? That's my plan on the euro here. Anyone got any questions?